गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वी वे हैव टॉकिंग अबाउट कैटलिस्ट कैटालिसिस एंड वी हैव सीन जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कैटलिस्ट मैकेनिज्म ऑफ फेज ट्रांसफर कैटलिस्ट कैटालिसिस देन व्हाट इज एसिड बेस कैटालिसिस. ओके, नाउ कैटलिस्ट इज डिफाइंड एज ए फॉरेन सब्सटेंस विच ऑल्टर्स द रेट ऑफ ए केमिकल रिएक्शन इट्सेल्फ रिमेनिंग केमिकली अनचेंज्ड एट द एंड ऑफ द प्रोसेस. ഒരു കെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷനിൽ അതിൻ്റെ സ്പീഡ് ഇൻക്രീസ് പണ്ണാൻ യൂസ് പണ്ണുന്ന സബ്സ്റ്റൻസ് ദാറ്റ് എൻഡ് ഓഫ് ദ റിയാക്ഷനിൽ അത് സബ്സ്റ്റൻസ് വന്ന് വി വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ബാക്ക്. അത് ഒരു ഓൾട്രേഷനും ഇരിക്കാതെ. ടുഡേ വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു സീ എൻസൈം ആൻഡ് മൈക്ലീസ് മെൻറ്റൻ ഇക്വേഷൻ. എൻസൈംസ് വന്ന് വാട്ട് ഈസ് എൻസൈംസ് ഈസ് എൻസൈംസ് ആർ പ്രോട്ടീൻ മോളിക്യൂൾ വിച്ച് ആക്ട് ആസ് കാറ്റലിസ്റ്റ് to speed up biochemical reactions in living organism. ഒരു ലിവിങ് ഓർഗാനിസത്തിൽ വന്ന് നിറയെ ബയോകെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻ നടക്കുന്നു. ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഡൈജഷൻ, റീപ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ, ലൈക്ക് ദ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ബയോകെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻസ് ഇസ് ദ. ആ ബയോകെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻസിൻ്റെ സ്പീഡ് ഇൻക്രീസ് പണ്ണാൻ ഗോഡ് ആ ലിവിങ് ഓർഗാനിസത്തിൽ തന്നെ സം കാറ്റലിസ്റ്റിനെ കൊടുത്തിരിക്കും. അന്ത കാറ്റലിസ്റ്റ് ദാൻ വി കോൾ ഇറ്റ് എസ് എൻസൈം. അത് വന്ന് പ്രോട്ടീൻ, നോർമലി അത് വന്ന് പ്രോട്ടീൻ മോളിക്യൂൾസ് ആയിരിക്കും. വാട്ട് ഇൻ പ്രോട്ടീൻ? ഒരു ഹൈ മോളിക്കുലർ വെയ്റ്റ് കോമ്പൗണ്ട് ഫോംഡ് ബൈ പെപ്റ്റൈഡ് ലിങ്കേജ് CONH ലിങ്കേജ് വഴി ഫോം ആകുന്ന ഒരു പോളിമർ ദാൻ പ്രോട്ടീൻ. സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് എൻസൈം? മീൻസ് എൻസൈംസ് ആർ പ്രോട്ടീൻ മോളിക്യൂൾസ് വിച്ച് ആക്ട് ആസ് ദ കാറ്റലിസ്റ്റ് ടു സ്പീഡ് അപ്പ് ബയോകെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻസ് ഇൻ ലിവിങ് ഓർഗാനിസംസ്. നമ്മളുടെ ഉള്ളിലെ അത് വന്ന് ഗോഡ് ഹാസ് ഓൾറെഡി ക്രിയേറ്റഡ്. നമ്മൾ വന്ന് എക്സ്റ്റേണലി ആഡ് പണ്ണുന്നില്ല. അതിലെ നമ്മളുടെ ബോഡീസിലെ ഇറുക്ക് അത് വെച്ച് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി ഡൂയിങ്. എൻസൈം കാറ്റാലിസിസ് മീൻസ് ദ പ്രോസസ് ഓഫ് എൻസൈം സ്പീഡിങ് അപ്പ് ദ ബയോകെമിക്കൽ പ്രോസസ്സിന് വന്ന് വി കോൾ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എൻസൈം കാറ്റാലിസിസ്. കാറ്റലിസ്റ്റ് വന്ന് എൻസൈം, പ്രോസസ്സിന് വന്ന് എൻസൈം കാറ്റാലിസിസ്. ലൈക്ക് അതർ കാറ്റലിസ്റ്റ് എൻസൈംസ് ആർ ഓൾസോ സ്പെസിഫിക്. അതും വന്ന് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി സ്പെസിഫിക്. ഇപ്പോൾ വന്ന് ഡൈജഷന് യൂസ് പണ്ണുന്ന എൻസൈം വന്ന് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ഓൺലി ഫോർ ഡൈജഷൻ. അത് വന്ന് റെസ്പിറേഷന് യൂസ് പണ്ണാതെ. ഈ സെൽസ് ഹാവ് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് എൻസൈംസ് ടു കാറ്റലൈസ് ദ പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ റിയാക്ഷൻ ഹാപ്പനിങ് ദ. ആ സെൽസ് നടക്കുന്ന റിയാക്ഷൻസിന് വേണ്ടിയ എൻസൈംസ് അങ്ങേയിർക്ക്. മെനി എൻസൈം ഹാവ് ബീൻ ഐഡൻറ്റിഫൈഡ് ആൻഡ് ഒബ്റ്റെയിൻഡ് ഇൻ പ്യുവർ ക്രിസ്റ്റലൈൻ. സയൻറ്റിസ്റ്റ് വന്ന് എൻസൈംസിനെ ഐസൊലേറ്റ് പണ്ണിയിറക്ക്. They have found and adu vandu crystalline formula they have got it. Any examples vanna, it's not one what is happening in, they have told some examples where inversion of cane sugar by invertase present in yeast. Cane yeast nalla living organism thil ullilulla oru enzyme than invertase adinte action enna vachala cane sugar le sucrose ne vandu glucose aayittu fructose aayittu convert pannana. That is what is it will do. In a conversion of glucose to ethanol by cymase present in yeast. Yeast lulla another enzyme de peru cymase. Adinte function vanna glucose ne vanna ethanolum carbon dioxide aayittu convert pannu. In a hydrolysis of urea by urease present in soybean. Soybean ഒരു ബീനുണ്ട്, അതിലുള്ളിലുള്ള ഒരു എൻസൈം ദാൻ യുറേസ്. അതിൻ്റെ ഫങ്ഷൻ എന്നാ വെച്ചാൽ യൂറിയ സോയാബീനിലെ യൂറിയയിലെ വന്ന് അമോണിയം കാർബൺ ഡയോക്സൈഡുമായിട്ട് ഹൈഡ്രോളൈസ് പണ്ണുന്നതാണ് അതിൻ്റെ യൂസ്. സോ ഇൻവെർട്ടൈസ്, സൈമേസ് ആൻഡ് യുറേസ് ആർ എക്സാമ്പിൾസ് ഓഫ് എൻസൈംസ് പ്രസൻറ്റ് ഇൻ ഈസ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് സോയാബീൻ. And each has its own function. One is used for inversion of cane sugar. One is used for conversion of glucose to ethanol. One is used for hydrolysis of urea. Then enzyme and enzyme catalysis. Mechanism and kinetics of enzyme catalyzed reaction. One proposed panniyada Michaelis and Menten. Two scientists. So that equation is what is known as Michaelis-Menten equation. വന്ന് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, ഇൻ 1913 ബയോകെമിസ്റ്റ് എൽ മൈക്കിൾസ് and Miss Mountbatten proposed a mechanism for kinetics of enzyme catalyzed reaction. Kinetic means rate kandupidikan, speed kandupidikan. And it was derived based on these assumptions. Angle derive panniya vandha some assumptions padidan. What are the assumptions is concentration of the enzyme is much lower than concentration of the substrate. Reactant in a column low concentration than enzyme. That is what is the catalyst. Catalyst characteristic when we studied we have seen low, very low concentration is needed. In a velocity measured is only initial velocity. Initial or rate matter than we have checked it. None of the product form reverts to the initial substrate. எல்லா ரியாக்டனும் வந்து ப்ராடக்ட் ஆகிட்டு கன்வெர்ட் ஆகும், அது வந்து அன்ரியாக்டட் ஆகிட்டு இருக்காது. எ ஸ்டெடி ஸ்டேட் கண்டிஷன் இஸ் ரீச் பிட்வீன் த ஃபார்மேஷன் ஆஃப் என்சைம் சப்ஸ்ட்ரேட் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் அண்ட் இட் டீஸ்கம்போசிஷன். அந்த ப்ராடக்ட் ஃபார்ம் ஆகினேன்னு இன் பிட்வீன் ஒரு சப்ஸ்ட்ரேட் என்சைம் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் ஃபார்ம் ஆகும். ஓகே, அந்த காம்ப்ளெக்ஸை வந்து வி அப்ளை ஸ்டெடி ஸ்டேட் அப்ராக்சிமேஷன் தட் ஐ டெல் யூ வென் இட் கம்ஸ். ஓகே, இனி according to them, this reaction or an enzyme catalyzed reaction takes place in two steps. First one, enzyme and substrate ude or enzyme substrate complex form aagum. Substrate nu sollana vandu reactant. Okay, ini aa complex next product free enzyme aayittu convert aagum. Okay, so first ஒரு காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் ஃபார்ம் ஆகும், திருப்பி அந்த காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் வந்து டீகம்போஸ் ஆகி ப்ராடக்ட் என்சைம் வந்து. ஈ இஸ் த ஃப்ரீ என்சைம், எஸ் இஸ் த ரியாக்டன்ட் தட் இஸ் சப்ஸ்ட்ரேட், இஎஸ் இஸ் த என்சைம் சப்ஸ்ட்ரேட் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ், பி இஸ் த ப்ராடக்ட். இன் ஓவரால் ரியாக்ஷன் என்சைம் இஸ் கன்சியூம்ட் இன் ஸ்டெப் ஒன் அண்ட் ரீஜென்ரேட்டட் இன் ஸ்டெப் டூ. சி ஓவரால் ரியாக்ஷன் பார்த்தாலும் இதில் வந்து ஃபார்ம் ஆகும், இதில் டீகம்போஸ் சாரி ஓவரால் ரியாக்ஷன் இது ரெண்டு கூட ஆட் பண்ணும்போது இது வந்து போம். ஸோ இ ப்ளஸ் எஸ் கிவிங் பி ப்ளஸ் இ, திஸ் வில் பி த. ஸோ இதில் வந்து கன்சியூம் ஆகும், இதில் வந்து ரீஜென்ரேட். ஓகே, ஸோ தட் இஸ் த ஒன். நவ் டெரிவேஷன் ஆஃப் மைக்கேலிஸ் மென்டென் இக்வேஷன்.
Michaelis Menten equation derivation. Okay, and enzyme catalyzed reactions involve the following steps. What were the step is, first is formation of an enzyme substrate complex, that is enzyme if you take it as E and S as the substrate, that is reactant, then that too will react to give a complex ES. And when it is a reversible process, so at equilibrium that the rate of the reaction, forward reaction be K1 and backward reaction be K2, that is the form complex have a chance to decompose back to enzyme and substrate. So the rate of that reaction is K2. Now step 2 is decomposition of the complex to product. So the formed complex will be converted to product and free enzyme. So this is what is the second reaction, and that reaction let it be the rate, let the rate be K3. Okay, if you are plotting a graph connecting the reaction velocity, that is rate of the reaction, and concentration of the substrate, you will be getting a graph in this order. That is, initially your reaction vessel, that is a beaker, contains only the enzyme, so the rate of the reaction is zero because there is no substrate for the reaction to occur. Now we are going to add the substrate. So what happens? Substrate and E will form the complex. So as the let this be the concentration of substrate, so this the rate increases. Again, when we are adding another substrate to it, what happened is more enzyme and substrate complex will be formed, so it will be increasing. So we can see that as the concentration of the substrate increases, the reaction catalyst or catalysis or the reaction velocity, rate of the reaction increases, and it reaches a maximum value that we call it as V maximum. That is, it is the maximum rate at which the enzyme catalyzes the reaction. Okay, that you have to keep in mind. So as the time increases, rate at which the enzyme catalyzes the reaction increases, and with the concentration of the substrate. Okay, with increase in the concentration of the substrate, then it reaches a maximum value that we use to denote by V maximum. So when it reaches this, the concentration of this becomes maximum, that is all substrate reacted. That condition we have the rate as V maximum. Okay, now we will come back to our equation. So what is the reaction happening is E plus S giving ES, and ES will again decompose to product and enzyme. So when you take this reaction, the first, that is enzyme and substrate forming, is a very fast reaction and it attains equilibrium very fastly. But the formation of the complex, formed complex decomposing to product, it is a slow step. So when you consider a multi-step reaction, rate determining step always will be the slow step. So in this case, the rate determining step is decomposition of enzyme substrate complex to product. This is the rate determining step. So the rate of the reaction of velocity V, we can write it as, this will be the one. Okay, this is a reaction ES converting to P plus E. So rate when the reactant depend panirkum. So K3 into concentration of ES, that is what is the rate of the reaction, or overall enzyme catalyzed reaction rate when it is equivalent to K3 into concentration of ES, where K3 is the rate at which the complex, that is enzyme substrate complex, decomposed to the product. Again, when you consider the case of enzyme substrate, rate of formation of enzyme substrate complexes, it is formed E plus S, ES is formed, that is K1. Okay, so K1 into concentration of E into concentration of S. What is concentration of E? It is a free enzyme available, and this is the concentration of the substrate. Okay, now rate of decomposition of enzyme substrate complex when you take, in this case we can see enzyme substrate decompose agumbodhu two possibilities irukku. One one, it is decomposed back to enzyme and substrate, and another one is product and free enzyme. So we have to consider both the cases when you take the rate of decomposition. So in this case, if this is the one, ES is converted to E plus S, that is K2. So that will be equal to K into concentration of ES. And then second case is ES is converting to product and enzyme. So K3 into concentration of ES. So rate of decomposition of ES is equal to K2 into concentration of ES plus K3 into concentration of ES. And we can take the common term outside, K2 plus K3 into concentration of ES. So let this be equation number 2, this be equation number 3, and rate of the overall reaction be equation number 1. Now we have to apply an approximation. That approximation's name is steady state approximation. What is steady state approximation is, in a chemical reaction involving an intermediate, what we take is concentration of that intermediate we consider to be remaining constant. Okay, in a reaction where an intermediate is formed, we assume the concentration of the intermediate to be constant. That is what is steady state approximation. Okay, and what is the intermediate here? Here we have enzyme plus substrate reacting to give enzyme substrate complex, then it will be converted to E plus product. So our intermediate is enzyme substrate complex. So according to the steady state approximation, the concentration of ES should remain constant. Okay, when it will be constant? Rate of formation of ES is equal to rate of decomposition of ES. Form agunna ES ore rate il speed il decompose ayala, when we check the concentration of ES, other remains constant. Illa, that will be change of concentration of ES with respect to temperature will be zero. This ES with respect to time, sorry, not temperature, time, this will be equal to zero. When it will be, the rate of formation of ES is equal to rate of decomposition of ES. Okay, now what happened if you say it like that? Rate of formation of ES is this and rate of decomposition of ES is this. So equation 2 should be equal to equation 3. Equation 2 is K1 into concentration of E into concentration of substrate. This is equal to K2 plus K3 into concentration of ES. Now we can calculate the concentration of ES. Concentration of ES is equal to this expression. We are rearranging this. We are bringing it to here. So it will become K1 into concentration of E into concentration of S divided by K2 plus K3. Here concentration of E is the free enzyme concentration. Concentration of S is concentration of the substrate and K2 plus K3. Now we'll take this expression, this term, that is K2 plus K3 divided by K1. Be careful here, okay? K2 plus K3 divided by K1, we can take it as KM. Okay, and that KM is called Michael's constant. Okay, so K2 plus K3 divided by KM, we take it as a constant, and that constant we call it as Michaelis constant. Now when you substitute in this expression, concentration of ES is equal to concentration of E into concentration of the substrate divided by KM. This is capital, these all are small k's. Okay, rate one is small k. In it, another problem is that the concentration of E cannot be measured experimentally. Free enzyme, that is what is E? Free enzyme. That is what? Now, when we are taking some total amount of enzyme, we are adding the substrate to this. Some of it will be forming E and some will remain as E itself. Some will form ES, some will remain as E. This concentration only, what is concentration of E? So that cannot be measured experimentally. So the equilibrium between the free and bound enzyme is given by enzyme conservation equation. There is an equation known as enzyme conservation equation. So we will calculate from this. What is enzyme conservation equation? E, concentration of E, subscript we are writing T. This is equal to concentration of E plus concentration of ES. What is this concentration of E to the subscript T is? It is the total enzyme concentration that we can measure, because we are taking initially the total enzyme in the beaker. So that concentration is, we written as concentration of E subscript capital T, that is total enzyme concentration. So that is equal to free enzyme concentration plus reacted enzyme concentration. Reacted enzyme concentration is concentration of enzyme substrate complex. Okay, so E expression, in we can calculate this expression. What will have this? You have to bring it here. So concentration of E is equal to concentration of total enzyme or total enzyme concentration minus concentration of enzyme substrate complex. So E is equal to total enzyme concentration minus concentration of ES. Now what we have to do, this is equation number 8, this we have to substitute in this expression. So what it will become? Concentration of ES is equal to total enzyme concentration minus concentration of enzyme substrate complex into concentration of substrate divided by KM. Because we are substituting in this expression, ES is equal to E into S concentration divided by KM. So this will be becoming this one, that is total enzyme concentration minus concentration of enzyme substrate complex. We will rearrange it. First K in, we will bring it to the left hand side. So concentration of ES into KM is equal to, we'll take S inside. So this into this. F total enzyme concentration into concentration of the substrate minus concentration of enzyme substrate complex into concentration of substrate. Now in this expression we have common terms, that is concentration of ES, concentration of ES. So we will bring this to this side. So the minus sign becomes positive sign. So concentration of ES into KM plus concentration of ES into concentration of substrate is equal to total enzyme concentration into concentration of substrate. Okay. What we will do again, rearrangement only, what we are going to do is take the common thing outside. Concentration of ES is equal to KM plus concentration of S. This is equal to total enzyme concentration into concentration of substrate. Then we can calculate concentration of ES, that is equal to total enzyme concentration into concentration of the substrate divided by KM plus concentration of S. And this, if you put it as equation number 9, this we can substitute in equation number 1. What was equation number 1? Equation number 1 was the rate of the overall reaction, V is equal to K3 into concentration of ES. That was the one. Okay, V is equal to K3 into concentration of ES. ES in the concentration, we will substitute this expression. So V is equal to K3 into total enzyme concentration into concentration of substrate divided by KM into concentration of substrate, where K3 is the rate of formation of the product, E is the total enzyme concentration, this term is concentration of the substrate, and this is a constant which we called as Michaelis constant. This is the equation which we call it as Michaelis-Menten equation. Okay, so what is it? Overall rate of the reaction, V is equal to K3 into total concentration of the enzyme into concentration of the substrate divided by KM plus concentration of the substrate. This equation can be further simplified. We have to assume that when all the enzyme has reacted with the substrate, the reaction will be going to be have maximum rate, that is V maximum. Then equation 7. What was equation 7? Equation 7 was that energy consumption equation. So total enzyme concentration is equal to E of concentration, free enzyme concentration plus concentration of the reacted enzyme. This is equation number 7. So equation number 7 will be becoming total enzyme concentration will be equal to concentration of the reacted enzyme. What is the reason? All the enzyme has completely reacted since no free enzyme is available. So this expression will be equal to 0. So this expression will become this. Either one we are going to substitute in equation number 1. So either one what happened, appa one what will happen is V maximum it will be, okay, rate of the reaction, that is equal to K3 into ES will be, what was equation number 1? This was equation number 1. V is equal to K3 into concentration of enzyme substrate. So, this will become total enzyme concentration and V will become V maximum. So, V maximum is equal to K3 into total enzyme concentration. So, total enzyme concentration you can calculate as rate, maximum velocity or maximum rate of the reaction divided by K3, rate of the reaction for product formation. Okay, now if you take it as equation number 12, equation number 12 can be substituted equation number 10. What was equation number 10? Michaelis-Menten equation. So what was that? Michaelis Menten equation is V is equal to Ka3 into total enzyme concentration into substrate concentration divided by Km plus concentration of substrate. So each term on the we are going to substitute Vmax by K3. So what will become K3 into Vmax by K3 into concentration of S divided by Km plus S. So K3 and K3 will cancel. Equation become V maximum into concentration of the substrate divided by Km plus concentration of the substrate. Okay, this is another form of Michaelis-Menten equation. So we got two Michaelis-Menten equation. One is V is equal to K3 into total enzyme concentration into substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. Or when we take the maximum rate, we can write it as V is equal to V max into concentration of the substrate divided by Km plus concentration of the substrate, where V max is the rate at maximum rate at which the reaction take place, concentration of substrate, Km is Michaelis constant. So this is the expression. So this expression is very important and derivation is also very important. So that is how we are deriving it. Okay.
Now Michaelis-Menten equation, rate of the reaction V is equal to K3 into total enzyme concentration minus substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration, or we can write it as rate of the reaction is equal to V max into substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration, where K3 is the rate of formation of the product, concentration of E to the subscript E is total enzyme concentration, this is concentration of the substrate, Km is Michaelis constant, Vmax is the maximum rate at which the enzyme catalyze the reaction. So this is Michaelis-Menten equation. Okay. Thank you.